Okay, so as promised, let's do another round of line fitting, right? Again, I'm kind of giving you a choice. I'm asking for a linear equation. So you have three choices. We already know we're not going to do that. We have the slope-intercept or point-slope form. And of course, it all drives, do I have the y-intercept or not? If I do, I'll stick with that guy. If I don't, I'm going to use that guy. So let's go look at our first data points, right? And when I look at this first grid, if I look real closely, we are in luck, right? Because there is my y-intercept, all right? So that tells me, let's just go ahead and find y equals mx plus b. Let's use that as our linear equation line form, okay? And we already know that b is 3, right? So b equals 3. What about the slope? Well, to find the slope, I just need to take any point. How about I let that be x1 and y1 and x2 and y2? Right, again, the slope of a line is consistent, so it doesn't matter which point you choose. So my slope, right, is my y2 minus my y1 all over my x2 minus my x1. And 13 minus 8 is 5, 8 minus 4 is 4, our slope is 5/4, and we're good to go. So what's the line that fits this? What are these solution? What equation are these solutions to? Y equals 5/4 x plus 3. And there you go. So again, there's the equation that has all these solution points. Easy to check, just plug them in and you'll see that you get what you got. Like real quick, 4, 5/4 of 4 is 5, 5 plus 3 is 8. All right, even up here, negative 4, 4 into negative 4 is negative 1, negative 5 plus 3 is negative 2. So there's a verification. So we're just finding, right, what equation has those as solution points. So let's go to B. That one was easy. B, again, the first thing we want to do is find a y-intercept. That usually occurs when x is equal to 0. Y, right, again, even though the columns, and I'm not labeling them, x is usually your first column and y is usually your second. So in this case, right, I don't see x equal to 0. So there's no y-intercept. So that tells me, let's go ahead then, right, and just use the good old point slope. I just need any point, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I got 6 of them. So use whatever you want. So really, it comes down to finding the slope. Again, you choose which one you want. It doesn't matter. How about I let this be x1 and y1, and let this be x2 and y2, just to be a little bit different. So what's my slope? Well, it's y2 minus y1. All over x2 minus x1. And if I do the math, I know I get 10 down below. 38 take away 54, let's see, 14, 12, 16, negative 16. Dividing everybody by at least 2, we get m equals negative 8/5. I think I did that right. So there's my slope, and there's my x1 and my y1. Again, you can use whatever point you want. That's how powerful this form is. But since I've already labeled that as x1 and y1, let's use that. So plugging in what I know, right? We have y minus y1 equals my slope x minus my x1. Let me make that a little cleaner. So y minus 54 equals negative 8/5 x minus 15, right? There's my y1. There's my x1, and there's my slope. Y minus y1 equals m minus x1. Okay, so there you have it. So again, that idea, we're reversing ourselves. We're trying to find the equation that has the solution points given, and you have two choices, slope-intercept or point-slope, and it all drives, do I have, this is the most important aspect of it all, do I have the y-intercept? If I do, like these two, we just cut to the chase and go for it. If I don't, like these two, then we pick a point, throw it in there, find my slope. You either count the slope or you use the formula, whatever rocks your world, it all works. Okay, we're going to go do some more wordy problems in the next couple of videos. So let's do some word problems next.